Hello and welcome to our screen recording. In this screen recording, we're going to install the MAMP software for the Macintosh. So we're going to download from mamp.org. So I'm going to keep this. I don't quite know why Macintosh is unhappy with that. And so I'm going to go into my downloads folder, and here I have this folder. And it's MAMP Pro 0401. That's because I downloaded it twice. And so I'm just going to click on this. And it opens an installation. And I'm just going to accept all of the defaults here. Okay, so it's been installed. So let's take a look at where it's at. So if I open Finder and I go to my computer and I go onto my hard drive, Applications, it's in MAMP. And I can start MAMP up. And this tells me a bunch. PHP info here is really useful because it tells you about the configuration of the system that you've got. I've got version 7 PHP, and it tells me where the configuration is for this. And so I'm going to go take a look at the configuration file, and I'm going to make sure I'm going to do Control F and look for display errors. So this is the problem we have when we're doing development with MAMP. Is that display errors is off, okay? And so I want to fix this by editing the initialization file, and you got to go to the right one, applications, MAMP, bin, PHP, PHP 7.10, PHP INI file, okay? Oh, and by the way, I've got this little MAMP control panel. This is your MAMP control panel. Starts and stop, little green dots means that it's running. So I am going to run the Atom text editor. And I'm going to open a file, and I'm going to go to my Mac. My Macintosh, Applications, MAMP, let's see. MAMP bin PHP, MAMP bin PHP, PHP 7.1.0. conf php ini. Yay, I found the file. So I open this up, and it's a nice little text file, and this is the PHP configuration. And I'm going to scroll down here. I'm going to use look for display errors. If you don't do this, there we go. So we're looking for this line. This is display errors equals off. It talks about this. Print out errors as part of the output for production websites. Do not do this for production. Sure. But we're doing development on our local hard drive, and so we want to turn this on. Because if you don't, you won't always see the errors. I'm going to turn up display startup errors. I'm going to turn those on. And so we want as many errors as we can in development. Of course, if you were running in production, you would turn these differently. And so what I'm going to do then is I am going to then save this file. Command S, I've saved it. Okay, now the thing you've got to do at this point is you've got to stop MAMP and restart it. Stop the servers. Now the servers are stopped, and if I go to refresh this, it'll blow up because it's not there. But when I start these servers, it'll come up, and I'll go to the web start page, and I'll look for PHP info. I can close these tabs now, and I should go down and look for display errors on and on. See, that's the success. That means that you are successful, and that's great. Okay, so let's then also write a simple little page. How do I get rid of it? Oh, I got to hit escape, I think. Yeah, there we go. So I'm going to make a little file. Hello from my first web page. Okay, so we're going to find out where this is at, localhost 8088, because this is now a web server running on your local computer. And if you go into your Finder, it is, well, let me start at the top. Where's my computer? Come on, computer. MacBook Pro, hard drive, applications, MAMP, htdocs. That's the folder we want to be in. Okay, that's the one we want to be in. So I'm going to take this file here. I'm going to say save as, and I'm going to go to MAMP, htdocs. I'm going to make a new folder called first. I'll make a new folder, and then I'm going to save this as index.php. Save. It also nicely highlights it. So now if I hit refresh here, you'll see that I got this folder name first. And if I go into first, the slash, if I don't have anything there, it's as if I typed index.php, because that's called for a folder. Index.php is the default file that a web server, one of the several default files that the web server looks at to load it. And so that's pretty much it. Away we go. We have successfully installed MAMP and changed the startup variables and written our first little program. Okay, hope it helps.